Hey guys, I'm doing my makeup. Well, I'm not really I'm doing my snowshoe. My girl's doing makeup. But anyways, I don't know if you guys tried a black nose strip thingy. And it's like, I don't
you
know.
You guys should. It was really good.
Yeah, you guys should try it. It's really good. I mean, when you peel it off, just be careful, because it can peel off your skin. No, I'm just joking. Right?
Right.
Stop, I messed up. Oh, my bum. Love
so
you.
Bad I messed up.
Oh, my God. Can I get a kiss? I always want kisses. Well, stay tuned, guys. My girlfriend's gonna make up her makeup tutorial soon. So, and also, she said she's gonna start right now. So, take it away, baby.
So, for my eyeshadow. My eyeshadow.
I said worm.
Anytime you put makeup on your face, you always have to prime whatever section. So for my eyeshadow, I use the Urban Decay eyeshadow portion. This is the original one. It's just basically kind of like a light tint clear coating. And what I use is a Eco Tools concealer brush, just because I don't like touching my eyelids. I don't really like this primer. I do like it, the formula is good, but I use the Eden one, which is like a little light brown tint, and this just makes your eyes pop more. And the palette I'm going to be using for my eyes is the one that my bebe bought me. It's the new and limited edition Too Faced Just Peachy palette. It smells so good, right,
bebe? Yeah, it smells good. I want to eat peaches. It.
And these are all mattes, supposedly, but some of them do have shimmer. So good.
Ugh.
So this is the palette. It has a gold thingy and a mirror. And you can say bebe. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take an all-over shadow brush. I have to find it.
You have those cases that can just stick to it.
I know. So I have my full eyeshadow, and I am gonna take this color right here. How do you pronounce that color? I can't. Peach.
Peach and merengue.
Oh, that's like that.
Italian.
And I'm gonna tap off the excess, and I'm gonna put it all over my eyelid. And some in the crease. And the crease is like this part right here. This is just gonna be your base. Now a little bit of like eyeliner booger. Damn, you're famous.
I'm not.
Yeah, I'm gonna do the other eyelid. He says he's ready to take it off.
No.
And then next, I am gonna take a more denser brush. This is the one from NYX. And I am gonna take the color, which one? Peaches and Cream. Just the bottom one down here. It's gonna tap. And this one you're gonna put all over your crease. So when you like close your eyes, is that little like, you know, the little flap right here. And you're gonna blend it upwards. And always use your brush at the end, because if you put it like that, you're gonna put too much pressure and it's just gonna look all patchy and cakey on your eyelid. And always do lightly strokes. He's like making faces. I know, I'm sorry. We need like a bigger
camera.
Yeah. And then I'm gonna take again, tap it on, and I'm gonna do the next slide. like about this palette is that it's not too, doesn't have a lot of kickback, and it doesn't explode when you fall out. That's what I was trying to say. Doesn't have too many fallouts. It's a good eyeshadow palette for those who are beginners also. I also have the Moda Renaissance one, which I love, but as a beginner, you get too much pigmentation and it just explodes everywhere. And it's hard to blend out like really fast. It's blendable, but you need to have a lot of time. This one, you don't have to blend it in too much. Oh, you almost dropped it.
Sorry.
Do you know when you love makeup when your palette falls and you're not as worried as when your phone falls? You care more about your eyeshadow. Now I'm gonna take this pointed concealer brush. Don't use pointed concealer brush. I don't have, it's an oval eyeshadow brush. It kind of looks like this. This one's from the one Eco Tools. Now I'm just gonna lightly tap the one from Peach Tart. And then tap excess, and then this, you're just gonna smoke it out in the corner. What you basically do is just do like a little Y, like I, like outline your eye, and then just circular motions, blend them in.
Well guys, right now I'm gonna take it off right now, and my girlfriend has primed her face.
With Fabulous Face Primer from Ulta. This is almost like a dupe for the Smashbox Photo Finish Primer, which I love. This one's a little bit just too, like, I don't know, too silicone. That's too much like silicone. Anyway, then I am gonna put foundation on my face with this Neutrogena one. I actually got it for free from Ulta, so it's not in my right shade. This shade is Natural Beige, and I am like a shade darker. So what I'm gonna do is take my Ulta foundation, and it's like in a compact. I'll show it to you guys. I don't know where it is now. In the color tan, and I'm just gonna set it with that, and hopefully it's my shade.
Well, guys, now it's my turn. Now time to peel this off and to see what the results are coming from. Oh, I can feel the paint.
This is the one I was saying. Yeah, it's pretty good.
Like, I can feel it, look. Oh.
So I'm just kind of like putting some all over my face. And then I'm going to take a beauty blender and put it in. I'm not going to damp it just so, because I want a fuller coverage. Yeah. Continue.
Now it's my turn. Oh, that hurt. Oh. Like, like you can see all that white stuff coming out from my nose.
Ew!
Ow, that hurt. Look, I'm already crying. Always peel slowly because it does really hurt.
And always blend upward.
Oh, wow, look at that. You know, it makes you cry. But look.
Ew, babe, that's disgusting.
This is why, guys, you gotta eat healthy and take care of your face.
Drink a lot of water.
Drink a lot of water. I always tell my babe. Now, back to you.
Still on step one.
She's still on step one.
You kinda need to, like, you still have, like, little pieces right there.
Wow.
You need to wash that off.
Since I took it off, you know how you had to have these little things? Just watch out, because you don't want to go walking around with it. One time I did, and luckily she told me. So you just go around with cold water, so you can close the pores off. And just slightly try to take it off. Don't press it too hard, but like, because you know, your skin is already like kind of sensitive right now. Just go lightly over it. Put some cold water to close the pores off, and then you should be fine. And just damp it down with dry towel slightly, and then boom, there you go.
So now I'm just setting it with the powder, and I'm using my NYX. I think it's called a buff brush. It's not the too soft one, and it's not the too like hard one. It's like the one in the middle. And anytime you blend and use like a brush, you always go upward. Because if you go downward and stuff, you will make a lot of streaks. Now for blush. For blush, I'm using this one. I'm not sure what's the name called, but it's from the Ulta brand. I'm just using a Equals Tool blush brush. And I usually don't bronze, so I'm not gonna do that. Now I'm gonna take my Equal Tools, what's this called? Highlight brush. And I'm just gonna dip it into this. This is the Urban Decay one. I got in a little sample thing. Just gonna do this. Let's go up. Ooh, it's so pretty. This is my first time using it. Oh, it's so pretty. I'm an Urban Decay girl, so yeah, I don't put it on my nose and stuff. And he's shiny. For my lashes, I am deciding to use the Benefit Rollerball lash. As soon as I actually finish using this mascara, I am not going to continue buying it just because it is not cruelty free. It is cruelty free in the US, but in China it is not. So I'm not going to be using this one anymore. Even though I like it. I heard good reviews about it, but... You know, you're supposed to start from the center, but this one's a little hard to get in the middle. For the bottom lash. Mm-hmm. That is it. We'll show you guys how we look in the sun.